Ipsy! No! Today's video is brought to you by Blue Land. Stick around and see how you can save 15% on your first kit. Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are having a lovely, wonderful, fantastic day. I feel super weird with my nails being colors. And like my raccoon squirrel brain like keeps catching the color in the viewfinder over here. And I'm like, what is that? We're gonna go ahead and get on into these boxes for today. And yes, of course, I have boxes. I did say boxes and I do mean boxes. We got this one. It literally has dust on it. We got this one. There's also this one. And then last but not least, we have this one as well. So, you know, just a couple. What are dust? This is the appropriate box for this quarter. You are supposed to get one of the Ipsy Glam Bag X boxes every quarter, I do believe. And they're like 58 bucks or like 60 bucks. Pretty expensive. They're pretty expensive for these little boxes. So let's go ahead here. We'll save this one for last. If you guys are only interested in this one, there will be timestamps, little chapters there at the bottom. You can just skip right to it and skip a lot of gabbing along with it because that's basically what we do here. We unbox and talk. This is an unboxing talk. Not just a regular unboxing. It's an unboxing and a lot of talk. As for the rest of these bad boys here, we're just gonna be opening them in a particular order because I don't know any particular order, but just whatever we open is what it happens to be. But before we get on into these, I would love to tell you guys about today's sponsor, Blue Land. I've been using Blue Land for going on a year now, and it feels great to be reducing some of these single-use plastic bottles that I have been using. And honestly, it also feels pretty great to be saving money at the same time. Blue Land products are effective, convenient, safe for use, affordable, and made of safe ingredients. Blue Land uses no single-use plastic in any component from their bottles to tablets to wrappers and shipping. These products are also EPA Safer Choice certified. This means the EPA scientists have evaluated every ingredient in the product to make sure it meets the stringent criteria. Plus, Blue Land is a great deal. The tablets start out at only $2, and if you buy in bulk, they're only $1.55, so it really adds up in savings. I personally got the Clean Essentials Kit, which comes with a multi-surface bathroom and glass and mirror cleaner. Plus, it also comes with a hand soap, and it includes the cleaning tablets with scents like iris agave, fresh lemon, and eucalyptus mint. Using your Blue Land cleaners and soaps is honestly a breeze. All you have to do is fill your forever bottle with warm to hot water, drop one of the tablets into the bottle, and then put the nozzle on after the tablet has fully dissolved, and then you can use it in minutes, no shaking or stirring needed. So if you'd like to try out Blue Land for yourself, all you have to do is click the link down below in my description for 15% off your first kit. Blue Land is sharing a very special offer just with you guys, so be sure to click that link below to get 15% off. All right, let's cut on into this box here. I do believe I'm supposed to get at least two of these per quarter. With Ipsy, I never really know what I'm gonna get. One, two, three, maybe one day like four will show up at my door. I don't know. Maybe they'll create an entire new account for me just to send me and charge me for another Ipsy subscription. Could happen. As of current, fairly certain, I've only ever signed up for one Glam Bag X, but like an unknown number will just appear at my doorstep. Oh, May! That was my birthday! The intense lawn care is starting up again. Somebody asked me recently in the comments, like, hey, how does Jimmy have any grass left? I don't know. I think he only cuts like maybe like a millimeter off a day just so he can do it daily, just because the man enjoys lawn care, I suppose. And I think it might be a little frustrating for like constant lawn care sounds during the summertime. Like if he wasn't so adorable, he has to be like 80 plus years old. He wears his little like lawn care earmuffs that match like the particular item that he's using for the day. Like he has orange ones that match his weed whacker. Like, so it's really adorable. Anyway, so the first box we have here is all the way from May. There's a lady on the front. Wow, the bend. The bend in that paper is giving her quite a Humpty Dumpty head. I don't think she actually looks like that. Fairly certain each of these boxes is like coordinated. That's something to do with like British royalty. Oh my god, what is that word? Curated. It literally says it right there. Curated by Madeline Petch. And I still don't know who that is. All right, so let's go ahead, dig on into here. The first thing I'm seeing is a box that has been ripped open on the top for some reason, and it's in a plastic bag. Drink pink. Pink drink. I guess that isn't like claimed by Starbucks or anything, so I don't actually know if that like the thing that is the pink drink is actually called a pink drink. I think people just call it that. So this is by Sunday Riley and it is called Pink Drink. There's supposed to be peptides that firm the look of the skin, and it has fermented honey in it. That's gross. I don't like regular honey, so I can't imagine I would like some nice old fermented honey. Ooh, it's cute. So this is a firming resurfacing essence, and yeah, it's a really cute little bottle, nice and glass and pretty, and it's from Sunday Riley, so I'm sure it's pretty expensive. I do want to smell it. I need to know what it smells like. It does smell a little alcoholic, like a little like fermenty, like, you know. It's been so long, and I just mentioned this in another video, like, yesterday. I filmed a video yesterday, or maybe the day before. Like, I can't remember things. But I was like, you know what? This product here, this new Rhodial Glass Primer, is the new Wander Beauty, because we haven't seen Wander in a while. I don't think she liked that. I don't think she liked the idea of being replaced. So she has made another appearance, and here we have something from Wander Beauty. Haven't even read the title yet. Glow Ahead Illuminating Face Oil. It has light diffusing optics that deliver instant luminosity. So I guess this is more of like a skincare product. It's not something that you like mix into foundation or whatever and gives like a luminosity through like shimmer or something. I think it's just supposed to help like improve your skin and like make you glow from like from your good skin. Okie dokie, tiny little box here. We have something from Keys Soul Care, and this is the very first time I think I've ever received any type of makeup product from Keys. This is a sheer flush cheek tint, and yeah, I'm actually halfway excited about this. I'm not a cream product person, but I've recently seen a video that might have made me change my mind, so hopefully this is nice. I don't really know how to get into it. It does look like a really nice blush shade. It doesn't seem like you get too much of it in here though. Oh, it's very sheer and very kind of like sticky feeling, almost a little like lip glossy feeling, but I think it could be pretty, definitely if you're wanting to go for like a very, very subtle, kind of like no makeup glowy look, but yeah, well, try. Oh, I don't have makeup on right now. That's right. My face is bare with the exception of whatever this is on my mouth for some moisture, and then just the tiniest bit of under eye cover so I don't scare the children. I am actually not a ghoul. I just happen to look like it with my dark circles. I'm just gonna go ahead and like, it's already so hot in here that I definitely know my cheeks are gonna be flushed here in like just a second. This is such a bad idea. My face is already extremely red and it's gonna get so progressively worse throughout the video for multiple reasons. Like this is, I shouldn't have done this. So who can really tell what like the blush is doing and what like just my natural rosacea is doing? But that does give just like the most natural looking like little flush to the cheeks with just the tiniest bit of glow. You guys can see that. So hot in here. It's so hot in here. I can feel the blood rushing to my face right now. Next up here we have Vacation Classic Lotion Broad Spectrum SPF 30 Sunscreen. And something about this, it's reading very like early 90s to me. Like this looks like sunscreen that my parents would have had in their beach bag at the Myrtle Beach. Like, no other beach existed. It was Myrtle or bust. Next up here we have a cute little pink box. This is from Saturday Skin. This is the Apple and Peach Rise and Shine Gentle Cleanser. It's just a squeezy tube of the cleanser and you get 4.05 fluid ounces of it. Very accurate. Sorry if I'm going through these a little quickly since we do have four of them and some of the stuff I might be trying on. I did want to kind of like run through them a bit quickly. Don't know why I grabbed two things at one time though. We'll go ahead and start out with this. Oh, a foundation! I could actually use this. So the next thing you have in here is from Nude Sticks. This is a tinted cover foundation and it looks like a shade that I might be able to actually use. It's in the shade Nude One. I don't know. It looks, you know, yeah, that's a nice sound. It's like a bird. Okay. So, I definitely am pale. I'm definitely not like a very tan person. I don't have like a lot of nice olive undertones or anything. I am fairly on the pale side, but this, quite light. It is quite light and I feel like it's definitely going to wash me out a little bit. However, it doesn't seem like a super high coverage foundation. It does also seem like it's straight pink. Did I swatch that over top of the blush swatch that was already on my hand? We'll go ahead and try it on. It does seem like it's gonna be nice and moisturizing. I just do think it's gonna wash me out a little bit. I think I'm gonna wait till the end to put this on because I'm pretty sure if I just have this and nothing else on my face right now, you know, I said I didn't wanna scare the children. I think that'll be counterintuitive because I feel like I'm gonna look pretty ghoulish with just this on. So we'll wait till the end until I can like put some other stuff on top of it. But let's go ahead and see what else is in here. Following that, we have a very prettily packaged item. This is super 90s, early 2000 looking to me. Like that is very just, it just screams Claire's. This is from TYS Beauty X Ipsy. So I guess it's a collaboration. It is a lip treat peppermint infused lip plumper. So that sounds kind of nice. I will go ahead and slap this on and see if my lips get any plumpier by the, you know, the end of the video. Oh, they're stinging already. Probably a good sign, I guess. Ah! burning my tongue. And then finally, the last thing we have in here, I feel like I've received this palette just so many times. Just so many. It's always the same one. It's from Iconic London. Is it the same? I don't know, maybe it's not. So this is just very familiar packaging to me, but this is the Sunset to Sunrise eyeshadow palette. We'll see if it's any different. I wanna say yes. I think the lip plumper is giving me a bit of a lisp. I wanna say yes that this is actually different, but I also like don't have the memory enough to remember if I've received this exact palette or not. But yeah, the colors actually look kind of interesting on the inside. I'm like salivating. I can't really talk. So I don't feel like we have received this exact palette before, but there have been many, many Iconic London palettes in the past that look exactly like this. Okay, so that's everything in the May box. I don't know if they give me prices in here. I'll see if I can scrounge some up. They do give prices. Okay, so let's see if I can remember everything. That eyeshadow palette is $62, and I don't know. I just don't know if I feel like the quality of the palette really reflects a $62 price tag. But anyway, the Saturday Skin Gentle Cleanser is $26. The Vacation Sunscreen is $18. I feel like, you know, Copper Tone probably does about the same. The Keys Soul Care Blush is $22. Wander Beauty Glow Ahead Illuminating Face Oil is $42. That little box of it. Is a roadmap. Sunday Rally product is $48. The thing that is currently burning my mouth is $30. And I think that's everything. Oh, the Nude Sticks. The Nude Sticks foundation is $36. So that is probably a pretty decent value there. Now, there is definitely a chance that we have repeats with these boxes. These could all be from May. I don't know. Maybe I got three somehow in May and only one so far in August. Maybe I have more coming. I mean, just every time with Ipsy, it's an adventure. Okay, yeah. we got another Madeline Pietsch. But these do actually come with variation, so hopefully we have some nice variation here. I will go ahead and pull out all of like the repeats first though, just to get those out of the way. So we have the Keys Soul Care. I'm assuming it's in the same shade. Yes, it is. Both of these are in the shade Grace, which I forgot to say before. Then we have the Saturday Skin cleanser thingy. Oh, is this a different color of Nude Sticks foundation? Yes, it is. Okay, I might have to use this one instead. I feel really bad about like swatching the other one, but this one doesn't look like it's gonna like make me feel like I'm floating through the halls of an abandoned like creepy home in the woods that a family's about to move into, but like the dog's, you know, unsure of the house and like doesn't want to go in the front door. Speaking about spooky stuff, I'm sorry guys, I know I talk too much in these videos, but speaking about spooky stuff, you guys asked me if anything like strange happened in my house, if I had any like occurrences like I did in my parents' house. I was like, not really. There is some like weird stuff that goes on in the hallway though, like the dogs bark at the hallway and they'll like stand there like arr, and they'll guard me in the bathroom, which like leads up to the hallway. And then literally the day that I told you guys that and edited that video, posted it, I'm sitting there editing the video and then the doorbell starts going dong, dong, which that's not the sound that our doorbell makes. It makes the ding, 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 you know, like doorbell sounds. For some context, this is the thing, the part of the doorbell that actually makes sound, and it's located in the hallway that the dogs bark at. Nobody was at the door. The doorbell was not ringing. It was just the thing in the hallway going dong, dong. And that's the only day it's happened since. I don't know. I don't know. Things to think about. Anyway, so let's see. We have another repeat here with the Vacation Sunscreen. Gonna be nice and sun protected for all my setting inside and not venturing outdoors until it's under 80 degrees. Ooh, this looks pretty. That's not a repeat, so I'll put that back in there. Yet again, another Iconic London eyeshadow palette. This one is the Sunset to Sunrise. So what do you know? We got two of them. Okay, we do have a few other products in here that are not repeats. So I really liked this box. I'm kind of excited about this. This is from Olivia Palermo, and I'm not quite sure what it is just yet, but I'm really enjoying like the vibe of this box. I like the green, I like the texture of it, the gold writing, everything about this I think is really pretty. This is a Primetime Illuminating Serum. Okay, so we have yet another illuminating serum that is supposed to be used, I guess, kind of more as like skincare. Ooh. Sorry, Wonder Beauty, that I'm a little bit more excited about like this illuminating skincare stuff than your little box of drops, but you know, it's just how it has to be. You know our history. So the bottle of this is beautiful. I love that kind of, it's like a really deep green, but there's almost kind of like a blue hint to it as well. The gold, so pretty. It looks like unicorn blood, but like the Harry Potter version, not like, you know, the typical like color, like the Harry Potter stuff. You know, the really kind of like pearlescent silvery white stuff. Yeah. Okay, I'm kind of excited about this. I will try this on before I try on the foundation today. Wild child. Oh, it's a perfume.
perfume.
I get excited about perfumes. This one, it should be interesting. So this is from Penrose de Parfum. It is the Wild Child Letter Out perfume. On the back, it says flirty, frisky, and fierce. This is a frolicsome tropical bouquet of tiare flower, jasmine, and vanilla. Frolicsome. That's definitely a new one for me. I'm assuming that's like some type of, perhaps like an adjective that explains like the feeling of running through fields of flowers. I'm feeling very frolicsome today. So this is what the perfume bottle looks like. It is a fairly standard looking perfume bottle. I am quite excited to smell this though. No one else is gonna know what I'm talking about unless you've been to the same exact doctor's office. Like, there's no chance anybody else is gonna know what I'm talking about. But every time I step foot into the place where I get my PRP done, you know, all the little shots in my head, this is exactly what it smells like. And it smells like you're shoving your nose into, like, a whole bottle of it. It's so incredibly strong and intense, but it is this exact, like, scent or fragrance. I think whatever theirs is some type of, like, air wick, air mister thingy. And maybe it's, like, a tropical version, so that's what we're getting here. It's kind of like an air wick tropical room spray scent. So it's not my favorite. It's not the worst thing I've ever smelled. It really isn't. It is quite strong, quite intense, but it's not my personal favorite because it's really not like the type of scent that I go for. Oh, there's something cute, 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 cute. There's a thing in here, a thing that I can use to do my makeup. That's fun. Okay, so this is the Tarte Creaseless Concealer, and I'm actually kind of excited about this because I have been looking for another concealer. I'm trying to do my own wedding makeup, so I do want things to look like more better than it typically does, so I feel like a little bit of concealer might be nice. This one also says it's a waterproof and 16-hour hydration and wear, which is really, really nice because of having to wear the makeup for like literally all day from like 10 a.m. to 11 p.m. and then also crying. There's absolutely no chance that I will not cry at my wedding. I watched a TikTok the other day where this grandpa texted his granddaughter and said that he was lonely and invited her over for a sleepover and asked her, I'm gonna tear up thinking about it, asked her if she could bring him some cinnamon applesauce and mashed potatoes. Bawling, absolutely bawling my eyes out. I couldn't even finish the video. So yeah, I do think I'm gonna cry at my wedding. So anything that's waterproof is probably good. Okay, so I'll get you guys prices for the new items here. Oh, and the palette. I totally missed the palette the last time. Sometimes I wonder, I do wonder, really, I truly do wonder if my brain is like doing okay. The palette was the very first thing, the very first price I told you guys. I made like a full comment about it. I talked to you all about it. And yet somehow, absolutely no memory of that happening. Okay, so the Tarte Concealer is $27. And then we have the Pink Rose Wild Child Fragrance. It's $60 for that bottle. And it does, it smells fine. It really does smell fine. It's not like a bad scent. I think I'm just having like way too much of like a scent memory associated with it, and then like at that place I get my head poked with many, many needles. And then the illuminating serum is $40, so I think that's all of the new items that I received in this box. All right, and now this one is where I'm really interested to see if this is going to be a third May box, or maybe this is a box from like the previous season. This one says Kimd on the side, so that could mean something. What is happening? Ipsy! No! Bad Ipsy! I want to roll this up and give you a little nose tap because no. No, I do not order three of these. I know I don't. I have screenshots. I did it last night. I just wanted to go through and just check my subscriptions just to see like what I'm technically subscribed to and what I'm technically not, because I'm gearing up. I'm getting like my evidence ready to present it to somebody at Ipsy as soon as somebody will actually respond to an email to be like, hey, look at this. I subscribed only two of these, even though I only signed up for one. I know I did, and yet you still charge me for three of them. And right there on my account, you can see it, that I don't order three of these. And yet here I am with another Madeline Pitch Ipsy Glam Bag X. And for that matter, why do I only have one right now? Why do I only, it's like August something, right? It's August 17th. I got that one a long time ago. I guess the other two are on the way. Not like I could check tracking or something for at least one of them, because technically, it doesn't exist. Sorry, Rin knows. I'm sorry, buddy. I'm getting worked up. I'm disturbing your slumber. I'm very sorry about that. Anyway, so let's go ahead through this third Ipsy Glam Bag X here, and then I'll update you guys eventually if I ever get the other two for these. And then I am gonna just get it together and talk to Ipsy about what the heck is going on, because I shouldn't be receiving different levels, different amounts of boxes each month, especially when I Don't order them!
As you can see from the screenshot, this is one of my 3 Ipsy accounts, so you can tell that I am a Glam Bag member because it's listed right there under my memberships, but it says I can still get the Glam Bag Plus or the Glam Bag X because I am currently not subscribed to them, and yet I am still charged for them and received them every single time. I have the date up there in the corner. This literally was taken yesterday, so it's not like an old screenshot, but I do not know why I am charged and sent these bags and boxes because I did not subscribe to them, at least on this one account. I have officially begun the process of talking to Ipsy about this. I mean, I talked to the Ipsy Glam bot because talking to an actual person is like impossible, but I have opened up a claim and I should be receiving an email at some point. So I will keep you guys updated on this.
Oh, the rosacea is popping now. Look at that. Okay, let's go ahead and just get the repeats out of the way. We got sunscreen, we're covered. Another Wonder Beauty, she makes a reappearance. Another thing that's gonna burn your mouth off. It does burn quite a bit. I mean, it's giving a little bit of like plumping, maybe. We have a third Iconic London palette. Not even gonna check. Actually, I am. Yep, it's still the same one. Nude Sticks, another one. And the shade Nude One, so I can haunt that family for a long time. Is this another illuminating serum? Did you just not decide which one to go with for the month? You had to have 3 different illuminating serums? I guess people typically don't get 3 Ipsy Glam Bag X's, but neither do I. So the next thing we have here is from Keys. It is a Let Me Glow Illuminating Serum. I do think their packaging is really pretty. I like the purple, looks real good, looks real nice. It's an illuminating serum. Still like it more than the Wonder Beauty one. Next up here, we have a product from Dew of the Gods, and I wonder if this one was also blessed by a Buddhist monk, because their other product was. Playdate is blessed by a Buddhist monk to inspire deep healing. I'm sure. So the next thing we have here is a Claydate Haya Activated Pink Clay Mask for deep nourishing. I do like clay masks and things like that. This is kind of like fun. It looks like it's cute and pink. I am going to be having like a bridal shower sleepover kind of thing. Just like a very low-key thing where like the bridesmaids and a couple of their friends get together and we're just gonna like, you know, have some charcuterie board and have some like fruity drinks and sit around and gossip with face masks and stuff on. So this might be a fun thing to use for that. I'm sure, you know, we have a large selection of things we could use for skincare, you know, because that's pretty much all you get in boxes these days. And then finally, last but not least, the final thing we have, and hopefully our final May box. Maybe this last box here will also be from May, you know, because why not? So the final item we have here is an Ultra Repair Wild Oat Hydrating Toner that is to soothe and nourish. I don't use toner because I don't know what it is, but this one seems kind of nice. Something about the wild oatness of it is kind of interesting. Gents. Well, it smells like almost nothing and it tastes like almost nothing as well. I wish I didn't know what it tasted like, but it is kind of like a milky looking color, which I don't need to probably describe to you guys because you likely know what milk looks like. Okay, so that was the last thing in that May box. Let me go ahead and find the new items for y'all in here so I can tell you the price. Yeah, Keys Soul Care item is $25. The first Aid Beauty item, the Oat Toner stuff, is $24. Was that all the new things? Claydate, the Dew of the God, $42 for this much? Like, the box is pretty small, so I'm assuming the bottle is even smaller. It's suspicious. That's everything in the final May box. Let's go ahead and move on to what I'm hoping is the August box, or I guess the, I don't know, these are quarterly. So like, what seasons are these correlating to? Is this the summer box and that was the spring, I guess? I don't know. Okay, so let's go ahead and get on in here. I'm telling you, if Madeline's little face pops out of here, somebody different, Alicia Keys. So we do actually have a different box. This is for August 2022. We did see several of the Alicia Keys items in the other boxes, so it's interesting that I'm seeing only one item in here actually from the Keys Soul Care line. So let's go ahead and see what we got. All right, starting out here with the Keys item, we have the Be Luminous Exfoliator. It seems like luminosity has been very important recently, which I'm okay with that. Oh, is this the one that's powder? Because if it is, I need to be careful opening it. Powder products and I like don't get along very well. They always end up everywhere or like accidentally like up my nose. So I think this might be a powder. Yeah, it is. And I have had this product before. So this is actually like little granules that I think are supposed to dissolve in water, and that's how it exfoliates. But again, really nice purple, pretty glass packaging. Next up, we have something from a brand that we just received, but this is actually a different product. So that is nice. This is the Essential Hydrating Oil. We had just received like a cleanser from the OC brand. It's toasty in here. Oh, so this is supposed to be for like an anti-aging moisture. It has 8 essential oils in it that's supposed to plump the skin. I do like a nice oil. I have been using this one that I received a while back. But you know, I could always change it up because my skincare routine is not a routine whatsoever. It's just whatever I feel like putting on that day. So anyway, there is that. Nice, pretty frosted glass bottle. Alrighty, next it seems like we have another skincare item here. This is the Organic Pharmacy. It is a honey and jasmine mask that's supposed to firm and moisturize. This is honey, squalene, and aloe for dry or dehydrated skin. I do think my skin is dry, and that's probably part of like the extreme redness issue, especially over here. This side's like, you know, I don't know. They're both not great, but this side's really red, and it does flare up, and I'm sure I do have some like rosacea. Oh, it's a mask. Yeah. I was about to say, oh wow, that's so interesting. It's a moisturizer that you put on for 10 to 20 minutes and then you wash off. But no, it's a mask. That's pretty standard procedure. It does say specifically you're supposed to wash it off with a muslin cloth soaked in hand hot water. It's very specific directions. Following that, we have another skincare item. So this is from GOTO. I don't think I've ever seen this brand before. This is the Skin Party with squalene. Again, shea butter and sweet almond oil. It's just to give your body the replenishment and fun it deserves. I like the color of this packaging. It's a nice, like, pale peach.
Okay, I mean, okay.
It says it will, and then, you know, it says things that are normal. Like, it'll hydrate you and that kind of thing. Keep your skin smooth and stuff. And then it says it won't ever chew with its mouth open. It's gross. Well, I mean, I would hope not. Oh, I really need to do these unboxings so I can try this stuff on and get something on my face because it is hot, it's inflamed, and it's angry. Okay, next up here, we have something from One Size. Is this Patrick Starr's brand? You remember, let me know down below if this is Patrick Starr's brand, but this is the Turn Up the Base Versatile Foundation Powder. Also interesting, we've gotten a lot of foundations here in these boxes. This is a medium to full coverage powder foundation to help blur unwanted texture. It's supposed to be buttery and buildable. Ooh, okay, mine came in the shade Fair One, so it should be very light. Ooh, pretty. Okay, so we have a cool little red compact. These people think I'm a ghost. There's absolutely nothing wrong with your skin being this fair. If you have skin this fair, I bet it's beautiful. I bet it's gorgeous. But my skin isn't this fair. My skin is very red, but also kind of yellow. So when you put something this fair on top of skin that isn't that fair, that's when you look ghost-like. If this is just your natural skin color, and you just happen to have like a beautiful fair skin, then you're not gonna look ghost-like. Especially because I typically do like self-tan, because I like to self-tan. So this will not work for me in that respect. However, maybe it would work as like if I just very lightly dusted it over a foundation as like a setting powder. I am worried that maybe it might be too full coverage to do that. It might still give off that kind of haunting effect. Next up here, we have something from LYS Beauty. This is the Aim High Multi-Use Liquid Highlighter. It says this is in the shade Brave, and then it says Champagne, but like that looks like a very, very gold square to me. I don't know about you guys, but that's quite gold. We'll see what the actual product looks like. All of their stuff is triangular. Like every single thing. Yep, triangular. That's gold. What do they mean, champagne? That's straight up gold. I thought it was foundation at first. Can you guys see that? Anyway, all of their stuff is square. Like the lid is square and then the actual bottle. I need to go get myself one of those little like things, you know, with like the shapes cut out of it, and then you put the block through the correct one, just as a refresher, because it's triangles. All their stuff is triangles. That's what this is. It's a triangle. Even the little tubes themselves are triangular, which I think is just kind of interesting. I'm just really not sure about this shade on my skin tone because it is very, very gold. Okay, next up here we have something from Huda Beauty. This is the Silk Balm Honey Kiss. I wonder if it's yellow. It is a Nutra Plumping Lip Balm. So again, we have another lip plumper, and it kind of has like a little bit of the same look, you know, like that iridescence that the last one did. The packaging's definitely a little bit different. It's just like the iridescence that's reminding me of the last one. It does have kind of a yellow tone to it, but I definitely don't think it's gonna show up yellow like on the skin. Oh, it smells nice. It just has that kind of a nice little like light vanilla scent to it. I don't think I'm gonna add any extra lip plumper to my mouth right now because it's just now starting to stop like the burning, the stinging pain that it was going through a little while ago. So I think I'm gonna skip trying this on, but yeah. And then finally, last but not least, the final thing we have in here, for a second, I thought it was from Wonder Beauty, and I had already said last but not least, and I was gonna have to change that statement. No, I'm just kidding. The beef between me and Wonder Beauty that never really actually existed has definitely died down since they've stopped being in every single subscription box that I've opened. This is actually from Patrick Toss. That's pretty exciting. This is a Major Glow, a softening lip mask. That sounds very, very nice. My lips are quite dry and crusty, even though I feel like I've been drinking a lot of water and staying super hydrated recently, but my lips are still just so, so dry, especially like right here around the edges. It could be because I do this all day long because of anxiety. Ah, okay, now I have something square to put in the square hole of my, like, you know, shape learning board. This is actually really cute. So it says Patrick Ta there on the top, and then it's just a little thing of like the lip product. It also has kind of like a subtle pepperminty vanilla scent to it. But yeah, it looks like it's just a lip balm. It has a little tiny, tiny bit of a tint. I doubt you'll actually be able to see it on the lips, but I'm kind of excited about this product because I would really like my lips to be a bit more smooth. So yeah, maybe that'll do that. All right, so that was everything in the August Glam Bag X. Let's go ahead here and see if we can get some prizes for you guys. So the OC oil was $68. That's pretty expensive. I almost said exciting. I guess it is exciting to get like an expensive product, but it's very expensive. The one size turn up the base powder foundation is $33. The Huda Beauty Honey Kiss Lip Balm in Queen Bee is $21. The Soul Care Illuminating Powder Stuff was $25. The LYS Liquid Highlighter in Champagne, which is most definitely gold. It's literally even gold right there on the piece of paper, is $19. Organic Pharmacy. I thought that, you know, something about that little bottle, even though like it wasn't the most well-designed bottle, I was like, this is gonna be expensive, isn't it? It's $74 for that mask. Yeah, so that there was that one. Will I be receiving two more of these boxes? I don't know. I am gonna get in touch with Ipsy, and hopefully I will have an update for you guys about that, because I know a lot of other people have had issues with MC and them charging them for things that they did not order, or like stuff never coming. Some people are telling me they're getting empty mailers, like all sorts of things. So I just want to go ahead, have a little chat with somebody at Ipsy. Hopefully this time someone actually gets back in touch with me, because last time I emailed them, no response, just not a single response. So let me go ahead and try on just a couple of these items. Let me see if I can cover up these cheeks with that foundation that we got, because my goodness, the redness, wow. I'm just gonna go ahead, do that off camera, and I'll show you guys what it looks like here in just a second. All right, you guys, so really quickly, here is everything that I tried on my face. So we have first the illuminating serum-y stuff, and it did do a lot of illuminating before I put on the foundation. It looked very nice and shiny on my skin. My nose did burn though, and I don't know why. Like the sides of my nose started burning like soon after I put it on, but my face feels fine now, so I don't know what that's about. I did use the Nude Sticks foundation in the shade 2.5, which I definitely think is a much better match for me than the lighter one, and it's okay. It did take some building up over here to kind of cover up some of that redness that I was generating throughout like my rant in this very hot room. But I did also have to use a little bit of the Tarte concealer, which I used under my eyes and a little bit here and around my nose, and to cover up my breakout that I had down here. The Tarte concealer does feel very nice and hydrating. I like the shade of it too, so that is actually something I'm considering using more frequently. I did try to use the One Size foundation as like a setting powder. I don't think that works though. I don't think that works at all. My under eyes are still very very sticky feeling, and if I had put on much more, they would have been super, super bright white because that is a very, very fair foundation. I did use more of the blush here on top of it, which I think gives a very nice glow, but there is also like highlight on top of the blush, but before I put on the highlight, there was like a nice kind of like sticky face looking glow. It was a very pretty dewy look. And then finally, I'm wearing the lip mask. I think that's the last thing right now. It does feel really, really nice on the lips. It doesn't really give like color or anything like that, but if you use it like before bedtime or just, you know, whenever, it does feel really nice. So I'm hoping it moisturizes my skin some. My face definitely feels a little bit on like the sticky, tacky side, which is not my favorite. Doesn't feel like things will probably like last for a long time, but you know, it's a very like light, dewy looking look. So yeah. Alright, you guys, so that is all I have for you all today. Thank you so very much for watching. Please go ahead and consider subscribing if you would not mind. It means the absolute world to me. I just hope you guys have a lovely, wonderful, fantastic day, and I'll see y'all next time. Bye!